Hey y'all, how y'all doing? This is going to be a very special and unique video because I'm going to be breaking down the root of the word capitalism and why the majority of people really do not understand what the word capitalism really means and how the system of capitalism really functions. This is going to be a mind-blowing video, so sit back, relax, and enjoy this content that I'm gonna drop because I can 100% guarantee that you've never heard capitalism broken down through this lens that I'm gonna provide you with right now. So to begin, most people believe that capitalism is this system of economics where bad business is done, where basically commerce is generated, people buy and sell products, transactions occur. A lot of people don't make money. There's a few people at the top making money. And those are kind of like general high-level stereotypes of what people believe capitalism to be. But if you're an etymologist like I am and you study words and how they're spelled and the meanings of those spellings, you can really understand that a lot of words have a lot of occult and invisible and hidden meanings. So when you look at the word capitalism, you see that it has a prefix and a suffix. So capital is the prefix and the suffix is ism. And when you look at the words capital and ism and you combine them together, you get this unique meaning of the system of lending and creating money. So how does that really make sense? Well, if you look at the word capital, capital can be defined as wealth or the accumulation of wealth. Well, when you break that down subconsciously, like wealth is typically measured in what? Money. Next, when you go to the suffix ism, ism means system of. So when you combine capital and ism, you get the meaning, the system of money. But if you really understand how money really works, it's really the system of lending and creating money. So what does that actually mean? What is capitalism? So now that you understand at a basic level that capitalism is the system of lending and creating money, you can surpass your previous understanding of capitalism as just merely a system of economics. Really, capitalism at its core is a system of finances. It's a financial system, and it's an extremely exploitative financial system at that. Because when you ask the average person, where does money come from? They will just assume, well, they know it comes from banks. Well, if that's true, then where do banks get money from? Because at the end of the day, everything in this world has an alpha and omega. Everything in this world has a beginning and an end. So if banks are getting money, where are they getting money from? Well, when you read fantastic books such as The Creature from Jekyll Island, you'll understand that most banks get money from centralized banking entities such as the Federal Reserve. But the question is like, where does the Federal Reserve get money from? And when you understand the capitalism, the system of lending and creating money, you understand that like money is just a concept. And entities such as the Federal Reserve literally lend and create money out of thin air. And so whenever money is introduced into society, whenever it's introduced into an economy, automatically there's debt assigned to that money. So in all reality, all money that enters into the monetary supply has debt attached to it. And theoretically, it is impossible to pay off that debt because you only have the money that you borrowed to pay off that principal. But on top of the principal is this thing called interest, which is debt. And so understandingly, intuitively, that capitalism is a system where money is literally created and lended out of thin air. And that's what capitalism is truly all about. Ultimately, this system of capitalism is truly broken, and I can't reemphasize enough how exploitative it is. Because we have humans all across the world who are working and exchanging their labor, which is their time and energy, for money, which is a thing that is literally created out of thin air. At its core, money is just a concept. It's nothing but a store of value. That's it. The real thing that is the most valuable object in this world is your labor, is your time and energy and your effort. The most valuable capital in this world is human capital and not monetary capital. And so this is one of the reasons why I love entrepreneurship so much, is because of this reason, is that I can be a true and ultimate capitalist and thrive within the system of capitalism. Because with my mind, I am able to create and lend money out of thin air, because I'm able to produce products and services that people are willing to pay for. And so within this system of capitalism, you do have the bankers who are the ones who are creating and lending this monetary or digital money out of thin air. But entrepreneurs like myself, entrepreneurs like you, entrepreneurs like others, we're the ones that are truly the highest level of capitalists, because we are actually creating tangible products and tangible services that have intrinsic value. See, the thing is, fiat currency does not have intrinsic value because it's literally paper, or it's literally a digital currency that doesn't even exist. But the things that you create, like this, or like this, or like that pen that just fell, these are real items that have intrinsic natural value. So in sum, capitalism, the prefix and the suffix, capital, money, ism, system of, means that capitalism is the system of creating and lending money, particularly out of thin air. And so for anybody who's watching this video, you now know and understand at like a deep root level what capitalism really means. It's literally all about money. It's a financial system that's exploitative at its core. But knowing this, in order to become a capitalist, the best way to achieve that goal is to become an entrepreneur. Because when you're an entrepreneur, you could use your mind to create and lend money out of thin air through the creation of a valuable business, through the creation of a valuable product, or through the creation of a valuable service that people are willing to pay for. So my question for you today is, now that you know and understand what capitalism is, are you a fan of capitalism? Why or why not? I'm really curious to hear your thoughts, so please be sure to drop your comments below. Furthermore, if you want to become the entrepreneur of your life, you can begin this process today by subscribing to this channel. Also, please be sure to click the notification bell to be alerted for whenever new content drops. Until next time.